This is Floor Wisdom Radio, Sean Anthony, the hip-hop motivator, talking to Malice, author of Wretched, Pitiful, Poor, Blind, and Naked. I'm taking comments and questions on Twitter at Sean_Anthony. And VA_Finest85 on Twitter says, can you ask Malice, is he still close to both of his parents since they are divorced?
Yes. My dad, he lives right around the block from me. My mom, she lives like about a mile away, and we're definitely still very close.
That's good. Because that affected you in the book, you know, you guys, yeah. You know, grew up in New York and then you moved to Virginia and you know, you had everything that, you know, kids could ever want. You didn't,
right,
you know,
so right.
I thought that was, you know, I was affected. I was a product of a divorce as well. And it affected me. And my parents got divorced, you know, I think I was about 13, 14 years old. So,
yeah. And that's the thing. I thought like divorce only affects young children, you know, but no, I mean, like my parents, they had been Mr. and Mrs. Thornton for over 32 years. So I thought we was out of the range of any kind of divorce, you know, and it also, in my opinion, showed me the effects of money if not handled properly. I think that's what I got out of that situation.
I'm gonna read a comment here on Twitter. The Lonely Soldier says, wow, I really need to start reading the Bible. He's listening right now.
Wow.
It's Floor of Wisdom Radio, Sean Anthony, the hip-hop motivator. My guest is Malice, one half of the Clips. Serious MC and author, Wretched, Pitiful, Poor, Blind, and Naked. Let me ask you this. Speak on humility. Because, you know, in hip-hop, there is an ego that must take place as an MC. Growing up myself as a hip-hop head and being a radio personality, there you have to carry some sort of ego.
Right.
But you mentioned in your book of having a friend going to the pawn shop for you to pawn some jewelry just so you could save face. And you also mentioned going into Patient First and running out so that no one knew who you were. Out of all the many situations you mentioned in the book, what was the one humbling moment for you?
The most humbling moment out of the book.
Or if it's not mentioned in the book.
Yeah, no, that book has everything. Like that book is aired out, bro. Like that book is aired out. But I would have to refer back to the forgiveness of my wife. I think that's what I'm like, really, you really gonna forgive me, you know? And I knew, or I felt as though I didn't deserve it, but when her forgiveness, really, like, that was the biggest impact on my life. Forgiveness, like, that says a lot, and that's what that whole Bible basically is built on, forgiveness. You know, and what the Lord has done for us. And people think that they're too messed up to have forgiveness. And it's just the opposite. It is a free gift that is there for you to accept. All you have to do is accept it.
All right. I'll also be posting up this podcast on flowofwisdom.com. So make sure you check out my site to get the updates and everything. We got Malice here on Floor of Wisdom Radio, Wretched, Pitiful, Poor, Blind, and Naked. I'm going to read a couple of excerpts out of your book, man. Here's one, and you just tell me what your thoughts are. I was already Run DMC's number one fan. Just asked the young Pusha T, who knew to run upstairs and rip one of their posters off my wall whenever we got into a fight. He might as well have shot me. Apparently, hip-hop is very, very rooted in you. You know, just talk about your love for hip-hop and the culture and the music.
Oh man, well, you know, I have an older brother who, you know, we were in the middle of the Bronx and were there when, you know, when hip hop was just getting started, and just to watch him break dance and to watch him you know, rap with his friends, it I was very interested in it, you know, just looking up to my older brothers as most younger brothers do. And you know, he kind of groomed me to getting into it. And then I have always had just my articulation has always been, you know, just very good. and I always seem to be good at you know, the storytelling and rapping and speaking for that matter. So I just was always into rap, and Run DMC, man, like, to me, they were everything, and, you know, just really, really dope. So they really, you know, got me into the to hip-hop.
Why do you think MCs feel the need to rap about or live out the violence that they rap about in their music? I mean, who pressured you to talk about selling drugs, having sex, and flashing money in your music?
Well, no one pressured me. Like I say, you know, Cliff's music is a real music. That's why our fans gravitate to us, because they know that it's a genuine music. Our music comes from a specific place. You know, and it's not so much, well, as far as the clips are concerned, we talked about, our canvas was what we talked about, because it's what we know and what we lived, but we didn't stop there. Like, we look at the metaphors that we use, the similes, the double entendres that we use, and when you couple that with the lifestyle that you know about, we were into the art form. Right. Of hip-hop. It wasn't just about saying, I do this, I do that. It was about how we said it and the things we compared it with and, you know, the sentence fragments and everything. So it's definitely an art form. Now, something, if it goes over some people's head and they don't get it, they may mistake it for, you know, just crack rap, as some people like to call it. But it is definitely much, much deeper than that.
Talking to Malice. This is Flow of Wisdom Radio. Sean Anthony, the hip-hop motivator, your host. Reading a couple comments on my Facebook page. Darrell D. Train Taylor says, we need more MCs that have a relationship with God. God needs to be pushed and talked about. It can change the entire culture. On Twitter, Miss Lay Dave on Twitter says, believe in no man, believe in yourself. If you believe in yourself, you're unstoppable. Great quotes from those lists. People are listening online and in the city as well. In your book, you talk about a spiritual advisor, Miss Alberta.
Yeah, man.
Do you still speak with her?
Definitely. We just shot a blog where I use Miss Alberta. Y'all can look for the new blog on Tuesday. It's called The Grandmother's Love. So definitely check for that. And Miss Alberta is also on my audio book. The audiobook, I'm looking to put that out the beginning of December as well. And it has all of the characters that are in the book. It's a listening movie. It's not just me narrating it. You'll hear all kinds of sound effects. You'll hear, you know, my wife, my Pusha, you know, my parents, like, everybody's participating in it. And it's fascinating to listen to. So y'all check for that as well, coming out real soon. You can go to Amazon and get that.
Who is guiding you in your spiritual journey now? And I want you to also talk about how important it is to have someone, you know that's guiding you, some sort of mentor or spiritual advisor, you know, in your personal walk as well.
Yeah, I have a lot of great support spiritually. Definitely my church, Bethany, on Camp Estella Road in Chesapeake, Virginia. Pastor Manley, definitely. We get a lot of spiritual food from him. Also, Jason Ma out in L.A., an evangelist, and also Bishop Harry Jackson, who is out in your area. I get calls every day. We speak on the phone, and it's definitely good to have surround yourself with people that keep you spiritually fed and you know, just help you to stay prayed up. And I just think it's important that people become aware of the Bible, not to shove it down anyone's throat. I think the best example is to be that example.
Right.
But don't know one side without the other, because you're shortchanging yourself.
Now, what do you mean by that, one side without the other?
Well, you know, a lot of times we tend to just take this world for what it is and live in it and conform to what we have always known, what we have always seen, what we see on TV, what we listen to, and we just we aspire to be those things. A lot of our hopes and dreams are based upon things that have been fed to us when we really don't know what we truly want. So what I mean by reading the Word of God, know what God says. Find out what He says. I mean, He is the Creator, so you owe it to yourself to see what the Creator says about me and says who I am. And then, after you know both sides, then you can make a smart decision as to how you want to live, what you want to be, you know, and how you want to do. But to just take what someone gives you and say, hey, that's what I want to do, that's not smart.